Here, nature has bestowed the best from its treasure. Snow-capped peaks with thick forest covers, fast-flowing rivers mesmerizing with their rapid currents, and at places their ripples take us to some another world. Rich variety of flora and fauna add yet another colors to the charisma of this place. Located on the farthest northeast expanse of India, this is Arunanchal Pradesh, the paradise on the earth, where even the sun prefers to shed its first ray. Also, the people living in this land of rising sun rejoice the traditional heritage of culture and rituals trailing since ancient times. But the human life in the remotes of eastern Arunachal Pradesh remained far behind in their primitive state, as there was no road connectivity to the modern world. In addition to that, the enemies sitting across the border had a rapacious eye to grab this beautiful land of splendors, putting ceaseless false claims. As a result, safety and security of the region of prime concern, for which road connectivity up to borders is an essential strategic need. So that not only our armed forces could scale mountainous terrains with their vehicle arrangements at the time of emergency, but also the people who since time immemorial have been climbing up and down in virgin steep hilly terrain to reach their destination should be lined with the main streams. The people who have been living at the mercy of God with no medical facility in remote villages from where evacuation of sick and old remained the distant dream. However, the task was beyond imaginable challenges, as the entire region is not only rough and steep, but also heavy, and prolonged rains of 8 to 10 months in a year trigger a number of landslides and slips. Then people living here witnessed a new dawn emerging in their lives when Border Roads Organization deployed its most enthusiastic and resolute workforce, the 44 Border Roads Task Force, for the road infrastructure advancement in Shillong and Siang valleys of Arunachal Pradesh.
This BRTF is known as Fearless 44, raised at Grab Center, Roorkee, along with three other BRTFs. During this period of last about 50 years since its raising, 44 BRTF has contributed immensely for development of wide spread area in northeastern part of Arunachal Pradesh by developing road infrastructure which brought revolutionary changes in progress and prosperity of a mass population inhabiting these areas.
Border Roads Organization was conceived and raised as a special organization by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, the first Prime Minister of India, on 7th of May 1960. The organization is responsible to provide civil construction and engineering cover to the armed forces of India during war and peace. 44 BRTF has been developing road infrastructure, providing road connectivity to the remotest border village like Manikong in West Siang district and Geling in Upper Siang district. It also facilitated smooth move of army to guard our international border effectively. Following the principles of the organization, the 44 BRTF, one of the oldest task force of Border Roads Organization, focuses on core competencies, ensures highest level of skills and proficiency in the entrusted construction activities. In the golden jubilee year of the Border Roads Organization, the task force nostalgically looks back at the long passage journey that has conferred a long list of outstanding achievements in developing road infrastructure, buildings, airfields, helipads, etc. Before settling down at Along, the task force moved to many places. Initially named as 3BRTF, the task force was renamed as 44MTF. And in another restructuring, it got its present name, the 44BRTF, which in the hearts of the people is regarded as the Fearless 44. Long back when the task force took over Likabali along road, the situations were not encouraging at all. The road was a rough track with sharp curves causing great difficulties. The gradients were quite steep and not suitable for traffic during rainy season. With handful of picks and shovels, the work was commenced and the task force carried the works on with limited facilities available for ferrying the stores and manpower. There came halt in the work progress in November 1962 due to Chinese aggression and the resultant panic created in the area. 3 BRTF along with 4 and 7 BRTFs was instructed to withdraw camps and destroy plants and machineries before withdrawal so that these might not be used by the Chinese against us. Soon all the task forces were ordered to move back to their respective locations. 3 BRTF resumed its works and all the abandoned equipments and plants were recovered and repaired. The Likabali along road was open for class 9 traffic during 1963 period and Bame Daporija road was completed and open for traffic during 1965. Later on, the task force took over the along Yingkiong and along Kaing roads. The work on along Yingkiong road was commenced during 1965 and roads were made through for class 9 traffic by 1968. The year 1971 was again a year of special missions for the task force. This year, the task force rendered remarkable assistance to the Indian Army during Indo-Pak War of December 1971. As the time passed, the task force carried its works on crafting the tough hilly terrains to a buzzing place with people heading fast towards overall prosperity. 44 BRTF has successfully handled number of assignments serving under Project Vartak till 17th of January 2009. Further, on the consequent rising of Project Arunak, it got separated from Project Vartak and became a proud part of Project Arunak, which is known as Pragati Kasurya, the son of progress. Creating road infrastructure in this region is quite different from areas of plain. The road construction work begins with ground survey called RSTC, road survey and trace cut by experienced engineers of 44 BRTF. Ground survey works are subjected to untold miseries, troubles and tribulations as the teams walk through the inhospitable, tough, virgin terrains without any track to obtain ground data. Also, the chief engineer, project and commander task force as well as the senior officers scale the rough hilly tracks to supervise works and motivate site executives to accomplish allotted construction works with quality in time-bound manner. After obtaining ground survey, detailed project report called DPR and estimates are prepared to be forwarded to competent authorities for sanctions. As the task force obtains government sanctions on DPR and estimates, the physical execution of works commences at ground under close supervision of qualified and experienced engineers. 44 BRTF has a quality control cell known as QCC. The cell functioning centrally under 44 BRTF carries out random checks on quality works under executions at sites. All works are executed ensuring full quality control with the help of site and laboratory tests conducted by executive units as well as by QCC of 44 BRTF. To accomplish responsibilities, the task force is allotted with 3 major executive units, 92 RCC, 105 RCC and 1448 BCC. To provide logistic support and repair cover to executive units, other supportive units allotted to task force are 1074 field workshops, 519 SS and TC, 1605 Pioneer Company, Central MI Room and 1462 MI Room. To support the construction units, the task force also has road maintenance platoons, 6 numbers, formation cutting platoons, 2 numbers, surfacing platoons, 1 number, permanent works platoons, 1 number, soil investigating platoon, 1 number. 92 RCC with its headquarters at Thumbin works in the very challenging conditions.
Initially, 92 RCC was raised in 1960 at Likavali in Arunachal Pradesh. This RCC is looking after many roads in the state of Arunachal Pradesh in West Siang district.
The initial days of 92 RCC were hard and harsh. Accordingly, unit is known as Hard and Harsh 92. The roads taken over were of no use and were covered with thick bushes. Bridges were made of rotten timber logs. Transportation of ration and POL was a major problem in the bad weather. Facing all the odds and difficulties, the RCC completed works on Along Kaing Road in the year 1970. The RCC took over Kaing Tata Road in the year 1981 and linked the road during March 1991. The Tato Mechuka Road was taken up in the year 1991 and was linked on 25th of June 2002. 105 RCC, famous as the Mountain Tamers, has its headquarters at Moing in the Upper Siang district. Since its inception, this road construction company has shown excellent results for its entrusted responsibility.
105 RCC is the vanguard of Fearless 44. And since its raising in the year 1982, the RCC has been rendering yeoman service towards the development of roads in the hinterland of Arunachal Pradesh, which in turn has not only led to the socio-economic development of the region, but it has also provided road connectivity to the defense and paramilitary forces deployed in the border areas of Arunachal Pradesh. 105 RCC is responsible for a road sector of 575 kilometers, which traverses through parts of Assam, north of River Brahmaputra, and 2 districts of Arunachal Pradesh. This mammoth road network is a result of tireless and dedicated effort of CPLs and men of 105 RCC over the past 28 years and which has earned us our befitting title, the Mountain Tamers.
The RCC started its activities with Dite Dimai Miging Road on the west bank of River Siang. The unit linked up the road between Dite Dimai to Moing during 1985. Further, Miging was linked by a Class 5 road in the year 1989. The unit commenced works on Miging Tuting Road in the 1990. To link Tuting, the remotest town of Arunachal Pradesh, with the rest of the country, the RCC has constructed bridges on rapidly flowing deep streams.
Now, I would like to share the foremost works in hands with 44 BRTF. This is China Study Group Roads. China Study Group Roads forms the utmost priority as far as a strategic importance is concerned. These roads to be progressed in time-bound manner and being monitored up to Prime Minister office on regular basis.
Out of 4 strategically important China Study Group Roads, namely 70 km Tato Manigam Road, 19 km long Manigong Tadadege Road, 12 km Mechuka Tongkrola Road, 19 km Tongkrola Yerlung Road. Tato Manigam Road was started 15 years back in 1995 to connect important border subdivision headquarter Manigong of West Siang District. Till recent times, the road could not take a shape until the chief engineer, Brigadier Deepak Sharma of Project Arunak, Commander 44 BRTF Padam Kumar, and OC 92 RCC Sanjay Kumar have taken bold innovative steps. They undertook torturous repeated site visits, walking through risky, steep, rocky, virgin terrain for 8 to 10 hours a day. Their self-involvement motivated the team in execution of works. As the sector was not accessible through ground movements, so all the machineries inclusive of heavy dozers etc. were airlifted from Tato to Manigong and Thayang for working in air-maintained sectors spread over 35 kilometers. Special equipments like crawler rock trails were utilized for speedy progress on steep rocky stretches. It is the result of great efforts put in by the team of 44 BRTF and 92 RCC that this most important strategic route was linked on 25th of March 2010 for vehicular traffic at least 1 year in advance from expected date. People were thrilled on the arrival of a light vehicle first time in local history of Manigaon. They warmly felicitated BRTF officers and the team for this unbelievable achievement as it frees the local population from the trouble and tribulation of walking through the tough and steep hilly terrain. This great landmark of achievement has opened doors for the socio-economic developments of the region, which was still now totally cut off from the outer world. The construction of some of these roads commenced long back, about 15 years ago in 1995. Yet, these roads could not be progressed with planned time schedule due to various ground eventualities and uncertainties. The BRTF is constructing these roads in the areas that have fractured rocks vulnerable to landslides that have caused heavy damage to the work progress. The task force has also lost a valuable human life when an unpredictable landslide crushing solid dozer killed the dozer operator. These setbacks could not deter the personnel of the task force. They continued their duties in the service of the nation and successfully completed assigned task responsibility under able guidance of their commander, 44 BRTF. Honorable Minister of State for Defense, Mr. M.M. Palamraju, who is the chairman of the Border Roads Development Board, visited the sectors under 44 BRTF on 21st of January 2010. Honorable Minister was accompanied with Sri Subhash Sharma, IAS, the Secretary BRDB, and Lieutenant General M.C. Badhani, B.S.